Hey girls, so we're gonna make a quick, simple little bow today. This is actually the one we'll be working on in the video, and what I do is sometimes I film it, then I go back and I can talk about it. But as you can see, it has the two boutique bows. It has some spikes in the middle, and then it has a nice little knot in the middle here. And I'm sorry for my nails. I chipped that, and it was like, okay, if I take off this polish and do something else, I'm never gonna make this video, because by the time that happens, you know, my daughter will wake up and all that good stuff. So here it is. I actually patterned it off of this one that I made a few days ago. This one actually came out bigger, so I think, as you can see, I gave you numbers that are a little bit smaller, but this makes about a, let me see here, one, two, it makes about a 4-inch bow, and the one I had before is about a 5-inch bow, so if you wanted one larger like this, like a 5-inch bow, you're just gonna have to add a couple inches to each of your bows to make them larger, but the spikes are still the same 5 inches. But anyhow, so we're gonna make this cute little bow, and all by hand. So you're gonna need different ribbons that I talk about in the video, but you are gonna need two 7/8 inch ribbons, which are the top boutique bow and the spikes. The bottom one is a 1.5 inch ribbon, and the little tie in the middle here is a 7/8 inch ribbon, but we'll talk about that in the video. I don't wanna make it too much longer. You are gonna need needle and thread, which I forgot to mention. Of course, a lighter to seal the ends of your ribbons, the edges, and a glue gun. And I didn't mention those things when I actually started making the items. So you want to make sure you have those things. Of course, a clip or a headband, whatever it is that you're going to put your bow on. And I put on a clip here. And I'll show you all about that. So if you're interested, please stay tuned. So for our basic bow, you're going to need a few things. You're going to need 27 inches of 1.5 inch grosgrain ribbon or silk ribbon, whatever you like to use, or satin, should I say. Satin's a little harder to work with, so if you're starting out, I would recommend a grosgrain. This is, I think these are all from Hobby Lobby. So, 1.5 inch at 27 inches long, okay? So I use this black with a white polka dot. That's the base bow. For the spikes, I'm just using this red His and Hers wedding ribbon. This one is more of a satin. And it's really meant for like decorations and things, but it doesn't have wires. So whenever you go to buy your ribbon, just make sure it doesn't have wire on the edge, unless you want that, but I don't see why you would. So this is just 7/8 inch ribbon, and you're gonna need three pieces cut at 5 inches each. Then you're gonna need one more piece cut at 4 inches for the middle of your bow, or however you wanna create your bow. But for the spikes, you definitely need three of these sections cut at 5 inches, okay? So again, 7/8 inch ribbon, three pieces cut at 5 inches long. And then for the topper of the bow, or the top of the bow, I'm just using this kind of damask fabric or print. It's a 7/8 inch ribbon, again, the width is 7/8 of an inch. And you're gonna need 1.5 feet or 18 inches of this. So 18 inches or 1.5 feet is the same thing, that guy. And then to cover, or whatever fabric, obviously, or whatever ribbon that coordinates with yours, to cover your clip, if you're using a hair clip, you're gonna need 3/8 inch ribbon, and you're gonna need just like a 4-inch piece of that ribbon, okay? So if that's to cover your clip, if you're gonna be using a clip, if you're gonna add it to a headband, then obviously that's gonna, you aren't gonna need the clip or that part. And these are the clips I like to use. The salon care ones from Sally's, they're like $5 for 100 of them, so it's very economical. And so let's get started. So, okay, I recently saw a really cool way to make your boutique bow without flipping the one side, cutting the edge, and all this other stuff, and then, you know, trying to eyeball it so that everything's perfect. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take my 1.5 inch ribbon, our base bow, and I'm just gonna fold it in half, because that's how you always start a boutique bow, right? You meet up the ends. Actually, this end is really jagged. And it doesn't even matter if it's jagged, because we're gonna cut it later, but I'm just gonna cut it straight just so you guys see. I'm not sealing the edges right now, because we don't need to do that quite yet. So I'm just taking my 27 inch length, meeting up the ends, and pulling it tight so that obviously it's folded right in the middle. So when you fold in the middle, what you're gonna do is really crease it really well. You can do that with your finger, with another implement, something that's not going to hurt the ribbon, but that's going to fold it really well for you. Get a nice crease, okay? And this I had seen on, I think her channel was like Bitty Bum, Itty Bitty Bum. If I can find it, I will put the information there. I don't know if it's her idea or if she saw it somewhere else either, so I just had seen it the other day real quick, so I don't even know the measurements other than cutting, you know, 27 inches folded in half, so obviously each side is going to be 13.5 inches. But you don't need to know any of that. That's what's nice about this. So we're really gonna crease that fold. Then you're going to come to the end, and you're going to fold down about an inch and a half, maybe? About an inch and a half of the ends, okay? So those are the two ends that matched up. We're just going to fold them down so that you're folding about an inch and a half or so. It's not rocket science. It doesn't have to be exact. You can go 2 inches, whatever you want. Whatever you fold here, though, is going to make a smaller bow, so make sure it's about an inch and a half. Okay, and we're really creasing that. So right now we've creased the very middle, creasing that, bringing it down about an inch and a half, creasing it very well. And now we're going to bring up the middle end and bring it up and butt it up right against the edge that you just made. We're not unfolding that tip there. And now we're going to fold it so that you're going to crease really well on this side here too. So it's basically in the quarter marks of the bow. And you're trying to really crease it really, really, really super well. And you see that the nice side of the bow is facing up, okay? So now when we undo this, we're going to have different marks. We're going to have a mark right in the middle, a mark on either side about a quarter inch down, a quarter of the way down, and then these little marks at the very end. So we're going to open up our ribbon completely, and you can kind of see those marks are on there. So you're going to take this first one. For this one, since it's a 1.5 inch ribbon, it's really wide. When I seen this tutorial, she said to put this crease against this crease, but like in an X formation. And it's kind of hard to do that with this because it's so wide and you want it a little bit loopier. So I'm going to make it so it's a little bit less of an X. Deeper, should I say. More of like a plus sign almost, okay? So as you can see, here's that mark. I'm laying it across this mark, okay? Hopefully you can see that. And it's just a guide. It's not like it has to be perfect on those marks, but that's how it is. So now we have that done. We're going to bring this edge up and to the next mark. So that next mark, I'm going to bring it up and cross it in an X formation to the first mark that we have made here, that first crease. Okay, on this ribbon, not the bottom part of the ribbon. Okay, so now we have another X. And as you can see, you have two loops. You have the top loop and the bottom loop. So now we're going to look for that next crease, which is down here, and we are going to go ahead and twist it so that that crease mark is going to come up under the very top fabric, under this end fabric or a part of the ribbon, and tuck it under there. Some people like to tuck theirs under here and leave the edge of the fabric out in the back. That's fine, do whatever you like, but I'm going to put mine under here. And again, you're taking that crease and you're trying to tuck it in with this crease that's on top, so you can kind of see what you're doing. It's not a big deal if you don't get it perfect at this point. You're just kind of knowing that that's where your mark is. That's where you want to kind of tuck that into the middle here. Now we're looking for the very last mark, which is at the end again. That last inch and a half mark that we did. And as you can see the crease, you can put it right as an X over this crease. And basically what you're doing with this one is putting it in the same direction as this piece of ribbon in the back. Okay, as that first loop. So basically you're going to crease it right there. Okay, sorry about that. I had to go check on a cake I'm making. Okay, so now you have your four loops, and you can do this any old way, however you like. You can do a running stitch. This is how I would do it. So I'm going to take my needle and thread. Of course, you're going to need a needle and thread. And so to start off with, you're just holding it. Okay, some people like to turn it over and work from the back. I'm just going to leave it face up just the way it was. I'm going to fold it in half. Okay, fold the bow in half. This is so much easier to do with this 1 inch, 1.5 inch ribbon because it's so wide. So I'm folding in half, and then I'm going to take the one side and fold it back down so that it's kind of touching back down right to where we folded it right in the middle. And then the other side also, we're just going to tuck it right back down. Okay, so both sides, you have like a little sandwich. So it should look like this nice and even. You have like these two hills, and then the two sides are down. And that's really nice and wide, and it's awesome. You can use floral wire, some people like to use here. I'm going to use the needle and thread. So I'm going to take my needle and thread and put it right through the center. And not try to, you know, poke myself here. And push it all the way through. And bring it around. And so now I brought it out. And we're just going to start wrapping the bow. And you're just going to wrap around a few times however you like. I only do like 3 or 4 times. I've seen some people do like 1,000 times. Some people don't even use a needle. You can just wrap around until it catches. But so then I'm going to finish it off. And the way I finish it off is I just kind of push back through some of the thread here. Oh, that nail's driving me crazy. Every time I look up in the video camera, I can see that it's chipped. Anyway, and then push through what you brought up there, and I did a messy job of it. But that's okay, you're going to cover it with lots of stuff anyway. And back through, just to finish off your tie. And I'm just going to then trim that off. And this is our first bow, and this bow you can use just by itself, just like this. Just put a little middle piece to it and attach to your barrette, and there you go. So it's a nice boutique bow. Super easy way of making it. You're not going to get it wrong. This edge isn't going to be in the wrong side, because I know sometimes when I first started out, I'm like, oh, this is facing the wrong way. Now, we do want to finish our ends. Unfortunately, my first one was kind of short, so I ended up leaving it back here, and I don't see it, so I'm not even going to bother with it, because honestly, that's not going to unravel. But if it does, and if you can still see yours, because let's say you left it a little bit longer, let's say you did a 2-inch mark instead of the 1.5-inch mark, you can just kind of dig it out from here. I'm not going to trim this anymore. I'm not going to cut it in any way, but I am going to bring out my lighter, and oh, there's a safety lighter, and just fray those little edges. Okay, so that's done. Now, on this front one, you're going to trim it however you like. Generally, when people make their boutique bows, they have that edge facing down, so if that's what you want, that's fine. What I'm going to do is just pull this back, and I'm going to trim that to a nice angle. Okay, so just give it a little angle. Just like if you had done it to begin with, but we didn't, we waited till the end. Now, you can do this at the beginning if you want, but it might get confusing, so if you're not sure which area to angle, I hope this makes more sense to you, that it's easy to do it and just leave it like this. Okay, so there you go. Gorgeous boutique bow. Our base bow. There it is. So now we're going to work on the spikes and then the topper bow, which is the exact same thing. We're going to do the exact same thing with the 7/8 inch ribbon. So for our 5-inch spikes, you're going to have 3 sections of that 7/8 inch ribbon. Like I said, I chose a little satin ribbon. And we're going to go ahead and fishtail the ends. So since there are 3 of them and they're kind of thin, I'm just going to stack them all together. You don't have to do them all together. You can do one at a time. This is just easier. I'm going to stack them all together. Fold them in half. Okay, so the stacks are all together. There's actually 6 layers here. We just fold it in half. And I'm going to do is just take my scissors. I'm going to get a better pair. Hopefully these will work. And just trim off in a slanted way, so that when you open it up, you have your little fishtails. Okay, so all 3 are fishtailed at the same time. So the other side again, just stack them up, make sure they're nice and even. And they don't even have to be even really, because once you cut it, you just want to make sure that you get into that lowest one if there's a short one or something, but it should be even. Okay, so you stack them up so that they're nice and even. And again, another slant. And if you do them one at a time, they're all going to be a little bit different, but if you do them all together, then they should end up pretty much the same. So there are my 3 spikes with the fishtail ends. And then you're going to take your lighter and just seal the very edge. Okay? And I'm going to do that to all the edges. So I'll come back when they're all sealed so they don't unravel. Okay, so now all 3 are sealed. It's funny, that shadow you see is from the bow. So big. Anyhow, so I'll put this aside. So now all 3 are sealed. We're going to bring over our needle and thread. Again, just put a knot at the end of that. And you're going to pick up each piece, and with each of these, what you're going to do is right at the middle of it, and I guess you can measure if you want, but I just kind of eyeball it. In the middle here, I'm going to fold it so that it's down in the middle, like basically folded down right in the middle, so the 2 sides are pointing up, and then bring each side down, just like we did the bow. So up, so what they call a valley fold, and then mountain folds on the side, so down in the middle so that the 2 edges come up, and then fold the 2 edges down. And I'm going to hold this in one hand just like this. And actually what I was doing, and this, some people like to keep working right, you just keep going. I don't know why my camera wants to not focus, there it goes. And it makes it hard, but if you want to, you can do that. You can fold it down and then use your fingers to kind of help you hold it and all that. What I do is after I do the first one, I'm going to take my needle and put it right through. So that's going to hold that guy together. Even if it opens up, it's not going to come off the needle. I push it kind of far down. So the next one, I'm going to do the same thing. Fold in the middle, bring the 2 edges down, and put it on my needle. And try to keep them just about the same so that they end up in the same spot at the sides, okay? So they're nice and even. They don't have to be super even, but just even enough. Of course, if you're going to sell bows, you want them to be perfect. So yes, you would measure and do all that good stuff. And then this is the last one. I'm just trying to get that nice crease there. and just kind of eyeballing it. Okay, so now you have the three on here, and they're kind of running stitch through them. And all you're gonna do is pull your needle all the way through. Okay, you have all your little guys. And I normally don't use off-color threads, but I just kind of want you guys to see the colors here. And you're gonna start wrapping, just like you did the bow. Just wrap around that center a few times. I'm only doing it a couple times because my thread's running low. And clip it off at the end, finish it off. And that's all we're gonna do for our spikes, super easy. You can even make a bow just with spikes and it looks really cute. Just layer up a whole bunch of different ones. So we're gonna do that, trim that off. And there's the next element to our bow. Really cute, ready to go. I'm just gonna put it to the side. And then what we're gonna do is go ahead and make our topper bow, which again is just the same boutique bow. Okay, sorry about that. So our last bow, again, we have the ends. I'm not gonna trim them quite yet, but if you can, if you want to, this is up to you. What you would do is you put them together with the nice side facing up, obviously, and you would flip one side over and then cut it at an angle, okay? You can do the same thing with that first one. I just don't do it. I'm gonna do it at the end so I know that I folded it right and everything's good and not have to worry about it. So we're just gonna fold it again, creasing that very middle, making sure we got a really nice crease. At this time at the end, this is our 7/8 inch ribbon that's 1.5 feet long. We're going to bring down about 2 inches at the end. So just about here. Bring that down. Crease it really well. Because this one is going to be on the very top and it's going to be very noticeable if something's not quite right. So let's fold that really well. Again, we're going to take that middle section, bring it up to the top. And this guy's going to be a lot smaller, very cute. Again, really nice crease on the end there. At the end of that section. Okay, so when we open it up, we already know what to do. We have our crease here and a crease here. We're gonna bring those guys together. Now you can bring it together in, like I said, a nice little X or more of a plus sign if you want it puffier, and I do want my puffier, so I'm bringing it so that that crease is almost slanted or, you know, crossing the other line there. So then we're gonna bring our next crease, and again, this one you want it very puffy too, so it's gonna be almost as an X or crossing that top crease, the top line where we creased it. Now we're gonna look for the next one, which is right back here. Sorry, no, it's hard to see. Right there. We're gonna bring it under, holding onto that crease, bring it under, and bring it under our piece that's hanging out here, and tuck it in with the rest of those creases. Just kind of get it right centered in there. And then our last crease is way back here, and we're gonna bring that one right up to the top, again, crossing it so much so that it ends up going over your loop in the same direction. You see it's going in the same direction. So it doesn't really matter if it's an X or a plus or whatever. It's gonna go in that same direction there. There's your cute little bow, perfect. And when they're smaller, you can, you know, the back looks kind of like this. You can either just fold it once or twice. This one, since it's still nice and wide because of the way we folded it, it's gonna be perfect. So I'm gonna fold it in half. And again, take one side, fold it back down, and take the other side and fold it back down. Okay, you really got to hold on to this little sucker. All right, let me just adjust that because this one's lower than the other side. All right, so now we're gonna take our needle and thread, again with a little knot at the end there, and take it right up through our bow. And again, we're gonna wrap it around and around. I just wanna make sure, there's my back, okay. I'm just gonna wrap it around and around and around a few times there. And since I left the back so long, it kind of gets in the way, so you make sure you tighten it up if you kind of see what you're doing. So I pulled it tighter and I'm gonna finish it off back here. I love the sound of the ribbon. It's nice and tight, just like makes a cool little sound. Okay, so I'm just gonna finish that guy off. And this time, since we have plenty kind of hanging out in the top and the bottom of the ends of the ribbon, we are going to slant both of them, cut them both at an angle, and finish them off. I'll put that to the side. Now, when you look at it, super cute. So this little bow, you're gonna kind of mess with it until it looks the way you want it to. So this end here, it's hanging out. I'm gonna cut it at an angle, however you want. If you wanna cut it the other angle, go ahead. I'm gonna cut mine this direction here, and I'm just going to seal that edge. Okay, you can tuck that back in however you like. This other side over here, I'm going to cut it at this angle. If you want to cut it this way, cut it however you like, okay? I know some people are like, oh no, it has to go this way or it has to go that way. It does not matter. In my opinion, it doesn't matter. Actually, I'm going to cut it this way. And I'm just going to finish that off. So if you're very particular and you want to cut it a certain way, go ahead. It's no big deal. So I'm just going to mess with this a little bit. Make sure it looks good. And there's our little top bow. Okay? So we're going to have our different parts. Let me bring this back. Our basic boutique bow for the bottom. I love the way that came out. So cute. And then our little spikes, 5-inch spikes. And then we have our damask bow for the top. And I'm going to go with a red bow in the middle just to bring more of the red into it. But if you want to use black, white, whatever it is, this is another about 5-inch piece of the 7th, 8th inch ribbon. And I'm going to fold it and make a little knot. Okay, so I'm going to very loose, just so it looks kind of natural, kind of pretty. And you're looking to get both of the sides so that the satin side, since this is satin, is on the top. Okay. I know there's a lot of talking, a lot of instructions. Sorry, guys. Hopefully you can follow along with me. And I'm going to mess with this until it looks perfect because there's like a little bump in here I don't like. So I'm going to keep messing with it until it looks like a nice okay. little knot. So that's all done. So I'm going to bring out my clip and I'm just going to take my little hair clip. And this is how I do it. You can do it however you like. I have a 4-inch piece of that 3/8 inch ribbon that I've already sealed the ends. And I'm just going to place a little bit of hot glue on that very back side to adhere this bottom part of my ribbon. And these little pieces that kind of hang out, I don't mess with them too much. I'm going to leave it alone for right now because I don't want to burn my fingers. And then you can just take them off later when they're dry. And I'm going to flip the clip over, so now we have the top facing up. And I'm just going to apply a little more hot glue right there and kind of down one side of the little pegs. You can put it on both sides, obviously. And I'm going to bring my ribbon down across there. This is mostly covered up by your bow at the end, but that's okay. Then we're going to open it up, and on the inside, apply more hot glue. And like I said, you can get rid of those little extras later. And just bring it right back in. So now you have a nice covered clip. You can do lots of things with. They sell them at the store already done this way, and obviously they cost more because, you know, they're already done for you. But let's bring back our base bow. And I'm just going to add some hot glue right in here. Just a little dab. Bring over my spikes. And I'm going to put the spikes right in the middle of the bow. Some people like to put the spikes big enough so that it's covering this bow, but then you can't see the bow. To me, I think you need to see it, but really the bow's there for to keep the spikes up, actually. But anyhow, so there we go. Hope that's nice and straight. Try to check this out as I'm going along. And then we're gonna take our last bow, and you can put it however you like. I'm gonna put it facing down because I think I want that little area facing down there. And put it right there. So another little dab of hot glue. Bring this little guy over. Placing him right in the middle. Okay. And so now I'm going to take my red piece. Then I'm going to go ahead and finish off the ends. The other thing with... See that? I was going to say, with the satin is, it's hard to burn the little ends off because it's more persnickety than regular grosgrain ribbon. So I'm going to add a little dab of hot glue there. So you have to be very careful with it. It catches fire much faster. And place it right in the middle. Kind of go ahead and turn it over. And making sure all your bows are lined up the way you want them. Bring each piece towards the back. And this little guy. And before I glue it down, I'm going to look at the bow and make sure everything's situated the way I want it before you really stick that down. I have all kinds of hot glue strands I have to cut off later. So like this little guy's over here. That's kind of what's pulling your spikes here and there. Okay, so you want to make sure it's where you want it. Okay. So now I'm going to apply some glue here. It's a pretty good amount. It doesn't matter. It's on the back anyway. And hold that down. And another little dab of glue right over the other side of your middle section here. And like I said, make sure it looks how you want before you really, really hold it down. All right. And last thing, we're going to add it to our hair clip. So I'm going to bring over the clip. I'm just going to put a string of hot glue there and add it however you like. I'm just going to take it and push it down right here on the back. And it just takes a few seconds to adhere to finish off and cool off. And that's it. So I hope you guys like this bow. I would clean it up a little bit. Very super simple, just two boutique bows in different sizes with some spikes. And I'll have pictures for you guys. And if you have any questions, please ask. And I will see you all at the next one. Bye now.